Let's talk about money. How are you tracking all of the different debts that you have? How do you keep organized with all of the different payments that you have? And do you know how much you're worth today? Not talking about what's in your bank account, but for those different assets that you have inside of your portfolio, how much are you worth? If you can't answer that question, you can benefit from this video because we are doing a deep dive on how to track your personal finances inside of Airtable. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Hey, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, a company that helps you to organize and automate your business with no code tools. Now, before I jump into the main topic of the video, if what I just said is of interest, if you want to bring more automation and organization to your business, you definitely want to check out my upcoming webinar. On this webinar, you will get the basic building blocks of putting together your own automation so that you can save up to 20 hours per week by automating those repetitive administrative tasks that we all do. This allows you to focus on that high level stuff and you're going to see massive growth in your business, in your career, when you stop with the mundane, repetitive administrative stuff. So definitely check the links below. Visit me at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration to get all signed up. And from there, wherever you take automation in your life is up to you. But without further ado, let's hop into this video. We are talking about getting organized in Airtable. And a lot of people have asked me this question over the years. They say, how would you organize my personal finances? And I'll tell you truthfully, for the longest time, I just said, listen, Airtable doesn't have a lot of amortization schedule type formulas. Excel, by contrast, has those formulas already baked in. And so for the longest time, I just recommended people to Excel. And I said, listen, if you're trying to track any debts or amortization schedule for your payments, just do it in Excel. They have the formulas for it. Airtable doesn't. Full stop. But in recent times, I've started to change my approach, and I want to show you how you can bring this into Airtable using those amortization schedules from Excel and jump right into a database that's going to track everything for you as you make payments against your loans so that you know exactly what your net worth is at any point in time. Let's hop in. The first place we got to start is with that Excel template. Now, listen, I used Excel a lot in my previous career as a financial analyst. If you followed this channel for a while, you've probably heard me talk about my past as an analyst. So yeah, I'm comfortable in Excel, but I'm not here to pitch Excel to you. I would simply suggest that you start with a template. So the one I have found here is on the Microsoft Office templates. Make sure you're going to a legit website and not some phishing or spam. But what I've done is I just downloaded this simple loan calculator and I've put it to use for me. I didn't have to do any of the creation. It's pretty straightforward and it's going to allow me to get the amortization schedule for any loan that's built on a simple fixed interest rate. So let's go ahead and hop into what the actual Excel file looks like. Inside of Excel, all I need to know are these four variables: loan amount, the annual interest rate, the loan period in years, and the start date of the loan. And once I'm able to put those four pieces to work for me, everything else is automatically calculated by my template. Again, we could talk about this for hours about how the Excel template came together. Not here to do that. Just find a good template that works for you and that creates all of the payments that you'll need for this particular amortization schedule that you're trying to create. Now, in this particular case, I'm imagining something like a home loan. So I'm saying, hey, there's a home loan, 500K. I've got a 3.5% annual interest rate. It's obviously a 30-year loan, as most home loans are. And then I put in a start date. And then all of this is automatically created for you. The principal of each payment, the payment number, the interest rate, the payment amount, all of it. So let's go ahead and take this and bring it into Airtable now. So what I do is I simply copy and paste all the way from my number all the way to my ending balance. And then I grab the entirety of this data set, which in this case is 360 individual payments over the 30-year loan. Now I'm going to take that information and paste it into my Airtable amortization table. Now before I do that, let's look and see that we actually have three different tables. I have cash out, which is a recording of my cash outflows. Then I have my amortization schedules, and this is going to pertain to all the different assets that I have loan payments on. And then I also have my assets. And for now, we just have the one home, but we'll add another as we progress here with this. So let's pop back into my amortization schedule, and I'm going to paste that in. So again, I'm getting the number of the payment date, the beginning balance, the payment amount itself, the amount that's going to principal, then the amount of interest, and then of course the ending balance on that particular loan. Now the last piece I have to do here is then link this payment schedule, this amortization schedule, to the asset that it pertains to. In this case, again, I only have that one asset, my Colorado home in this example. So I'm going to connect my payment schedule to my asset. And then also you notice here that my amortization schedule connects to my cash outflow table. So in my cash out table, this is where I'm actually recording when I make a payment and how much that payment is. So let's jump into this in just a little more detail. Obviously, we have a link to the payment that we made. And remember, the payment that we make is already predetermined by the amortization schedule. So when I go to make the fourth payment on this loan, we already know what that payment amount is, how much of that payment's going to principal, and how much is going to interest. Let's just do that now. I can click add a record here on the bottom, and it creates this new record that I can then link to my payment. In this case, it's going to be payment 4 that I'm making on the Colorado home. And I have to then determine when the payment was actually made. So in this case, we see that the date due is 3/2. This is, of course, looking up the payment due date on the amortization schedule. But here we need to denote when we actually made the payment. So let's say we got it a few days before it was due. We made it on, Feb 28. Now we see the payment amount is $22.45, and this is being looked up from the payment. This is the amortization link, and we're looking at the payment amount here. But where things get a little more complicated is we can pay additional principal toward our loan at any point in time. So I might decide that not only am I making the $22.45 payment, but I might be putting an extra $500 this month toward my principal balance. So how is that going to get reflected on the back end? Let's flip back to the amortization schedule, and you'll see that a little bit more math was put into this. So yes, we've now linked to our cash outflow, which suggests that we've made this payment. And then we're also able to look up the additional principal from the payment as it was made on our cash outflow table. So here's where we're bringing in that $500 overpayment that we're making toward the principal balance. And now we're able to calculate the actual amount that we pay toward the principal on this payment in particular. Of course, we know that the principal payment for this particular payment is scheduled to be $793 and change, but we put in an extra $500. Therefore, we can calculate $1,293 and change. We do that simply by saying, if the cash outflow exists, meaning that we've already linked this to a cash outflow on our cash out table, then I'm going to take the principal and add the additional principal amount if there is one that came in here. And there we go. That formula is working perfectly. Now, how do we roll it up back to our asset to know what our net worth is at any point in time? Flipping back into the asset now, we have a few different things to talk about. Number one, the starting value of this property or whatever the asset is. In this case, I'm imagining that we bought a $600,000 home, then we put down $100,000, and then of course that would mean that we financed the remaining $500,000. In this case, these two numbers are being plugged in, these are entered, and this third is calculated. So this is simply saying take the starting value, subtract the down payment from it, and that's the amount that was financed. Now, pro tip here, this amount financed, if we go into our amortization schedule, better equal the beginning balance of the first payment. There's nothing tying these two things together, so we need to make sure that we put our numbers in correctly when we set up our own template. Now, back into assets here, we can then roll up the total amount of principal paid on this particular asset. We do this by looking here on our roll up. We're looking at our amortization schedule, and we're looking at that total paid principal field and summing it. Let's check this really quickly. Now we see that our total principal paid is $38.11 and change. We can flip to our amortization schedule and we can look at these four pieces, and sure enough, that total principal is $38.11 and change. So that roll-up field is working perfectly. Now lastly, we need to calculate our equity, and this is what we actually own out of this asset. That is to say, this is the amount of the asset that we own, not the bank or the lender. So drilling in here, we're looking at the current value, and please note that this is a new field altogether because our assets are going to change in value over time. Real estate tends to go up, our cars tend to go down. So whatever the current value of that asset is, we want to start with that. Again, this is just a plug and play number, so as you're checking your own current net worth, you can be putting in numbers here that reflect the value of your different assets. So we're taking that current value, we are subtracting from it the amount that's financed, in this case, $500,000, and then we're adding back the principal that we've paid, because the amount of principal that we've already paid is no longer owed on that original loan. So we're able to now see how much equity we have in this asset. And at this point, it's really straightforward. We see we bought a home for $600,000. We put $100,000 in, so obviously, given that the value of the home hasn't changed, it's still $600,000, well, our equity is roughly the down payment that we put in, plus the few extra dollars that we've put towards principal. But as this house appreciates, let's say it goes up to $700,000, we need to give Airtable a moment to think, but as soon as it's caught up, that equity formula will now reflect an additional $100,000 in equity. So now we are able to look at a glance and see that this particular asset, we have a net worth of $203,000 and change. Now let's go ahead and add another asset and another amortization schedule to this so that we can track our progress in another area. Now flipping back to Excel, again, using our template, we're going to go back and assume that we are buying a car this time. $80,000 for this car, maybe we're getting 5.5%. And it's going to be a 5-year loan. All right, we'll start, keep the start date here, and we need to do the same thing we did last time by grabbing all of that amortization schedule. So go ahead and copy that, flip back into Airtable, and we're going to create new data in our amortization schedule. I'm going to go down to the bottom and add a new record here, and I'm going to paste all of the data that I just copied from Excel. And sure enough, it comes in beautifully. Now we have to, of course, link it to our asset. So let's go ahead and say, here's our new car. I'm going to go ahead and link now to that and copy this and paste it down for all of the payments for that particular asset. So far, so good. Now let's imagine that we've made a few payments against that asset. I'm going to add a couple of those here. I'll go ahead and add some dates here. Let's say we paid them on the date due, and in this case, we might pay an extra $500 in principal as well. Now flipping into our assets, we need to make sure that we put in the right starting value and down payment for this particular new asset. Now in our case, we know we financed $80,000 for this car. The starting value may be $100,000, and we would have put down $20,000 in order to finance the remaining $80,000. Giving Airtable a moment to think, we see the formula caught up with us. And now we have to determine what the current value of this asset is. Now being a car, it probably depreciated the moment we drove it off the lot. So maybe it's currently worth $75,000. And when we put that number in, again, we have to wait for Airtable to catch up for just a moment. We can see that our equity on this is actually negative. Even though we put 20% down and applied additional money to principal after making our first couple payments, we are still in the red on this particular asset. But at a glance, we can see that we have a net worth, at least between these two assets, at over $200,000. I hope you got a ton of value out of this. In an upcoming video, I'll show you how you can add your cash inflow to this database as well, so that you get a more holistic picture of your personal finances. If that's of interest, make sure you subscribe to the channel so you don't miss that upcoming video. Leave any questions you have below, and I will see you in the next one.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts, We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.